Hi, I'm Mark Johnson. I was hurt September 18th of 2006 at a sawmill. This is what's left of my arm after I was sucked into conveyor belt. Before my injury, I was just like anybody else. All my friends would get together, we'd play sports. I played hockey, soccer, baseball. I still remember the day I started. Mark, you got any questions for us?
Nope.
Why ask questions? And I look dumb. Mark, wear your high-vis vest. Oh, I don't have time for that. Mark, wear your helmet. Oh, that's just a pain in the ass. I don't need to wear that. The first day I got my locks to lock out a machine, I used them once. And I realized that first day, what a waste of my time. I wish I did lock out the machine I was working on. I'd still have two working arms right now. September 18th, 2006. Day I'll never forget. My boss said, hey, go in there if you have extra time and clean up. Well, in there is underneath a running conveyor belt. 15 feet above me is the chipper. Chips up all of the garbage wood at the mill. Underneath those conveyor belts was a big, huge pile of chips. Go in there with my shovel. Start scooping up these chips. Did I shut that machine down? Nope. Why didn't I shut that machine down? That's a pretty stupid thing to do, isn't it, Mark? Well, now that I think of it, yeah. Now that I think of it, I wasn't really safety conscious ever. Thought safety was a big waste of my time. It's never gonna happen to me. Never ever. I was 21 years old. I believe that's a statistical peak age that males think they're most invincible. I actually don't do too bad of a job. Get most of these chips out of there, except for some of the chips got between the belts. And I stuck my hand in between these running belts. My left hand. Started scooping away and scooping away. Before I know it, my whole left arm was sucked into the conveyor belt roller. My forearm wrapped around the roller, breaking my forearm in half, pulling me into the whole running machine. It did not stop. I lost all feeling right away in my left arm. But I was in pain. Not from my left arm, but from my back. The way it was pulled in, pulled my back against that running conveyor belt. I felt all of that. It ate the shirt off my back and the high-vis vest, and it didn't stop there. It continued to eat the skin off my back. Scream as loud as I can for help. Nobody's gonna hear me. I'm 15 feet underneath the loudest thing in the mill, the chipper. I scream and scream until I pretty much don't have much of a voice left. And then I start to fall asleep. The chipper was located just outside. There's an overhang from outside the mill. I can see a little bit of sky. I made my peace with God, knowing I'm gonna die, and the only actual thing I said out loud was, please God, make it stop. After I said that, the machine shut down. I scream out for help immediately, thinking somebody shut it down. Nope, nobody was there. After I left the hospital, I asked all the people on my shift, did you guys shut it down? No, nobody pushed the button to shut it down. I'm not here to tell people to believe in God, but I definitely do. Our drop gate operator, his job cannot continue without putting the garbage wood down the chute. Well, the chute is now backed up because the chipper's not chipping up these pieces of wood. And I hear him walk up. All he says to himself is, now that it's quiet, why the fuck is this off? If I can hear him, he can hear me. Help! He stops what he's doing. He looked over the side and yelled over the edge. Mark, is that you? Yeah, I'm sucked in the conveyor belt, get help. People came, they unbolted the roller. I got pulled out of there, put on a plank, put in the back of an ambulance. Right before they're about to knock me out for the drive out there, I look at the ambulance attendant. I say, do you think I'll ever play baseball again? He looks at me and he's just like, I don't think so, but try and fall asleep. We're gonna knock you out. When I woke up in the hospital. My whole left side is covered up in white, wrapped up, so I can't even see my left arm. And you see how I can do this with my right hand? Felt like I was doing it with my left hand. I wasn't. This phantom feeling, or whatever you want to call it. I didn't think my injury was all that bad. And I look up and I look to my right. There's my parents there. There's my mom, crying away. My dad trying not to cry. The weirdest thing of that whole situation, seeing my parents together. They haven't been together since I was one. I had to say goodbye to roughly 30 people who showed up at the emergency room. That's a lot of concerned people. My injury was not just affecting me, it was affecting all the people around me. After I got home from the hospital, every day in the morning and night, I had nurses coming into my house, into my personal space. You know how embarrassing it is at any age to have somebody come in and help you wash yourself? So what do? I sit around and think and think and think. Not one day went by where I didn't think about killing myself. Every single day, I thought about how I was gonna do it and if anybody was gonna miss me. I realized that a lot of people do care about me, so I stayed alive. I did my best to get out of my depression, and it finally worked. I started to play baseball again. I started to do anything I could to bring back my old lifestyle. You know, not asking questions it's just stupid. You know, you think it's a dumb question, who cares? But you gotta think about where you're working. Go in there and clean up, they said to me. Well, what's in there? Did I think about my surroundings? No. Don't just assume that your workplace is safe. You need to be aware. There's absolutely no reason why you shouldn't ask any questions. You're more of a dumbass for not asking a question than you are for asking the question. If you're not gonna live for yourself, live for somebody else. Think. All you have to do is think. Think smart. Don't be an idiot. You wanna be a hero to your bosses and coworkers? Just go home at the end of the day. No amount of money is worth a limb or your life. You need to remember that. I would pay any amount of money to get my left arm back. Any.
Mark is a survivor, but will live with the effects of his injury for the rest of his life. His message is clear. Be aware of your surroundings while at work. Never be afraid to ask questions about the tasks assigned you. Pay close attention to safety gear and policies. You have a responsibility to yourself, your coworkers, and your family. Don't make assumptions, make wise decisions. Your injury or death will affect everyone who knows you for the rest of their lives. Think about that and work safe.